Welcome to this introduction of using test automation in Zephyr for Jira. In Zephyr for Jira, you can have multiple test cycles that have test executions that can be manually updated. To integrate with test automation, we will go to the Zephyr menu and look at the test automation screen to automatically update these test executions within these test cycles. In Zephyr for Jira, you can create test automation tasks that will synchronize test results from a specific automation framework into a specific test cycle and folder within Zephyr for Jira. Let's create our first task to synchronize our Selenium test results with our test cycle in Zephyr. For this automation task, we're going to stick with uploading a file directly from our machine, but users can also use ZBot to synchronize test results from remote machines using a Java-based remote agent. Let's go ahead and finish selecting the upload import method and fill out the rest of the information for this task, providing a name, a description, and selecting the framework that we're going to use, in this case, Selenium. Zephyr for Jira can access multiple different results files from very popular test automation frameworks like Cucumber, any framework using JUnit or TestNG reports, and Selenium. Let's select the file from our local directory that we're looking to import. Then we can choose where these test results will be synchronized. So we're going to go to release one, choose our appropriate test cycle and folder. Now you can either create a new folder and test cycle or import them into existing ones. We'll make sure it's assigned and has some dates associated with it. And you also have the option to schedule this automation task to execute on some interval. Lastly, let's select our reporter. And now we're ready to execute our Selenium UI test synchronization. When executing the automation task, Zephyr will either create a new Zephyr test in Jira or update a Zephyr test that matches the description of the test results you're importing. Once the automation task has completed, you'll see a success message and you can go to the cycle summary to see the results. Let's go to the cycle summary now and go to the specific sprint and folder to see the test results that we just synchronized. Now we're able to see our Selenium test results easily in Jira to understand which ones passed and which ones failed. Let's go to a specific test execution and provide more information for our testers to understand. Here we have our failed test, that is the Jira issue Smart 14. We can link this automated test result to either a new or existing Jira defect. This will help us improve the reporting capabilities from these automated results into the rest of our Jira work and provide a comment so our testers can understand what exactly may have occurred during this automated test. Since this was a failure, the automation task also included a log file from the Selenium execution. Now that we've seen the test execution created from the imported Selenium test result, let's look at the Jira issue that's behind this test execution. Smart 14 is actually an existing Zephyr test that has been updated multiple times through various automation tasks being executed. We can see the different releases and sprints it's been included in under test executions. We can add more test details to describe what the automation test is doing. And from now on, we can just run the automation task and update this Jira issue with multiple test executions. Thank you for watching. Please refer to our documentation for more detailed information on using test automation with Zephyr for Jira.